It's Freedom Files with James Burns.
Happy New Year. It is the Freedom Files podcast for Sunday, January 1st, 2012. I am James Burns, and the past couple nights I've been going out and about with some friends. Friday night I went to a local acoustic show downtown Shreveport. Then, of course, for New Year's Eve, I got dragged out again and checked out a couple cool rock bands. One of my favorite local bands in the Louisiana area is the American Tragedy. They've been around for a while, an awesome band, great guys. And once again, I was smelling like cigarettes and having my eyes burning. But other than that, you know, I mean, I survived and a couple of happy-go-lucky moments and got a chance to hang out with some friends, and that's always fun. So I made it back in one piece, and I thought I'd go ahead and kick things off instead of waiting till Monday, because Saturday afternoon I came across something that really didn't surprise me. A week or so ago, you had several candidates fail to meet the deadline to be on the ballot in Virginia, such as Rick Perry, Newt Gingrich, Bachman, Santorum. They all failed to meet the deadline. The only two campaigns that did what was required to be on the ballot was Mitt Romney and Ron Paul. And this is no big shock to me. Virginia Attorney General intervenes in GOP primary ballot dispute. This one's coming from Faux News, also known as Fox News. Virginia Attorney General Ken Chusini, I don't know how to pronounce that, is intervening in the Virginia presidential primary dispute and plans to file emergency legislation to address the inability of most Republican presidential candidates to get their name on the ballot. Okay, here's my issue here. It's not the fault of the state of Virginia that these campaigns were unable to get on the ballot. The fault lies with themselves. They knew the rules. They knew they had to get a certain amount of signatures on the ballot. They knew they had to do this and this and this, and they failed to. Therefore, they shouldn't be on the ballot. Mitt Romney, Ron Paul, their campaigns met the requirements, so they're on the ballot coming up on Super Tuesday. So it's unfair to do this because it's violation of law. They're like, okay, well, we're going to have a do-over. It's like a little kid, you know. I lost the game. Can we have a do-over? I mean, what are these presidential candidates? Children? I'm sorry, Gingrich and Bachman and Santorum and Perry. Your campaigns failed to get on the ballot and get the 10,000 signatures required. They say it's too stringent. Well, I mean, I think they had the same ballot requirements in the 2008 primary. And as far as I can remember, all the presidential candidates were able to do so back then. So why couldn't they do it this time around? Well, sorry. Tough shit, as they say. But this is really no shock at all. I mean, look what happened when Rahm Emanuel was running for mayor of Chicago. There was absolute proof that the man had not been a resident of Chicago for a year prior to the election. Therefore, he was ineligible to run for mayor. And you had several judges say, no, he can't run for mayor. But Rahm Emanuel, like the little crybaby he is, went above those judges who had a 2-1 decision against him being on the ballot in Chicago, and he got it overturned. The same thing is happening here in Virginia with the Attorney General and also the governor, Bob McDonald, is going to support the emergency legislation as well. And that's bullshit. It's absolute bullshit. I mean, back in 2008, a prime example of the hypocrisy. Here in Louisiana, we had a massive hurricane, and it really tore up, you know, Baton Rouge, and not as bad as what happened to Katrina in New Orleans a couple years prior, but it made the election process a lot more difficult. And at the time, I was a libertarian, registered libertarian, a Bob Barr supporter, and we weren't able to get Bob Barr on the ballot here because of all these little issues, but they didn't allow us the time to get all the signatures and notarizing stuff into Baton Rouge, so they despite the fact that the Libertarian Party took the state of Louisiana to court over the matter, because the Libertarian Party is a third party and doesn't count in the eyes of the two-party puppet show powers that be, it didn't count. And bear in mind, this was when I was still a Bob Barr supporter. I've talked about that several times, and eventually I did get fed up with the Bob Barr campaign. I finally said, you know what, this guy's not a real libertarian, and I bailed on him. But that was like a month later, after all these shenanigans with what happened over the election process. Fortunately, we had Ron Paul on the ballot thanks to the Louisiana Taxpayers Party. So I was lucky enough to be able to vote for Ron Paul for Election Day 2008, which was kind of cool because he came in third place behind Obama and McCain. But the point here is, it doesn't matter if you like or dislike a candidate. If you follow the law and get on the ballot, then you will be able to be voted on by the voters on Election Day. However, if you don't follow the rules, if you don't get the necessary signatures and all the other jazz, then sorry, too bad, so sad, see ya, bye-bye. And that's the way it should be in Virginia. But unfortunately, you know exactly what's going to happen. They're going to overturn this, let these crybabies have their way, and be on the ballot for Super Tuesday. I mean, it's just a double standard, and I'm sick and tired of it. And the only two people that should be on the ballot for the GOP primary coming up in Virginia are the two candidates whose campaigns actually followed the rules and did what was necessary to be on the ballot. And I don't like Mitt Romney, but I respect the fact that his campaign did what was needed to be done in order to qualify for Election Day, Super Tuesday, coming up in a few months. To reiterate, it's not the fault of the state of Virginia, or the laws on the books in the state of Virginia, that these candidates did not get on the ballot in time. It is the fault of the candidates and their campaigns. Now, as you well know, I'm a Ron Paul supporter. However, if he was unable to get on the ballot in Virginia because of his campaign's failure, I wouldn't be crying foul. I would be saying, you know what? His campaign dropped the ball. It's their fault. What's the point in having a law on the books if there's always going to be a double standard? Like, it's okay if you break the law, but it's not okay if we break the law. For example, the other night I was heading home and a cop just raced past me on the parkway. I mean, it was, what was the speed limit? I think it was like 40 miles an hour. I was going right under 40. And this cop was going like at least 70, maybe faster. And no lights, no anything. He was just racing down the road. And this isn't the first time that I've seen this happen, okay? I've seen it happen plenty of times, all right? They're racing down the road at 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning, and no emergency lights on, no sirens, no anything. They're just speeding because they can. I've seen incidences of cops in front of me at a turn light, not indicating that they're going to turn. But if the roles were reversed and I was in front of the cop at an intersection and I turned left without indicating I was going to turn left, guess what? The red and blues would be flashing right behind me. The cop would be reading me the riot act and would write my ass a ticket. That's exactly what would happen. Of course, it would be a 20-30 minute process of license, registration, proof of insurance, and all that BS. But the point is, I can't pull over a cop when they're speeding down the road, flooring it 100 miles an hour, however fast they were going, without any emergency lights or anything on, or whenever they fail to indicate that they're going to turn left or right at an intersection or stop sign. But it's okay for them to, you know, read me the riot act and revenue collect my ass. The same thing goes with celebrities and our elected officials. I mean, perfect example, Lindsay Lohan, all the trouble she's gotten into. You think she'd be in jail for a couple years. No, she keeps going in and serving a couple days in jail, house arrest, probation, community service. She always drops the ball, goes back to court, yada, yada, yada. It keeps happening over and over again. But if it was just Jane Q. Public that got in trouble over the same issues that happened to Lindsay Lohan because she's a nobody, an average citizen that no one really cares about, well, she'd be in the slammer right now. And then you go over to the elected officials in the den of crooks known as D.C. I mean, they commit all sorts of violations of the Constitution and Bill of Rights on a daily basis. And it just keeps getting worse and worse. I mean, the corruption is just out of control. Most of them come in, and by the time they get out of office, they're worth way more money than they were when they were first initially running for that position of Congress, Senate, whatever. So there's definitely a lot of corruption there, but if it was just an average citizen, they would just throw the book at you. The corruption, the double standard when it comes to the rule of law, and the violation of the Constitution and Bill of Rights are huge pieces of the problem of what's wrong with this country regarding how bad things have gotten. And the only candidate right now that adheres to the rule of law, that has all his life and followed the Constitution and Bill of Rights and respects individuals' freedoms and liberties, is Congressman Ron Paul. And I bet you his campaign wouldn't be pulling this same shit in Virginia that Perry's and Bachman's and Santorum and Gingrich's campaigns are. If his campaign dropped the ball, he'd say, well, you know, we failed to meet the deadline. We failed to do what was required. That's our bad. We just move on to the next state. And that's exactly what these crybabies should be doing. Not, change the rules, change the rules. So unless there's a huge outrage from the state of Virginia and across the U.S. over these shenanigans the Attorney General is trying to pull off by, you know, going online to, I don't know, governor.virginia.gov, governor.virginia.gov, and calling the governor, who is at the moment going to support this initiative, and tell Governor McDonnell under no circumstances should this be overturned. You can email him, call him, fax him. It's all there, governor.virginia.gov, and tell him this is a bunch of BS, that these candidates did not follow the rule of law, therefore they should not be on the ballot in Virginia, and to overturn this is basically a big slap in the face of the state of Virginia, as well as the entire election system. But I digress. You can always join us online, freedomfiles.us. From there, we are linked up to several social sites, such as Facebook and, of course, YouTube. You can subscribe to us, freedomfilesus. You can also follow me at Twitter. And you can check out past shows and past guest interviews, all linked up to freedomfiles.us. And, of course, at YouTube, freedomfilesus. And over at Podbean, freedomfiles.podbean.com. And I will join you Monday for another edition of the Freedom Files Podcast.